Mathias Mpuuga warns government to use terror attacks to settle political scores. Hello, welcome, and thanks for taking your time joining us live on PROJOURN Media TV. That brings the latest news and the latest updates in the country and across the world. It may be your first time to be on this platform, but kindly do one thing, subscribe, turn on the notification button. All these updates will come to you in time. But let's take more look into some of these details. The leader of the opposition, Mathias Mpuuga, has rallied the population to cooperate with the security agencies in efforts aimed at fighting the terror threats, but with a caveat: not allowed to be used by the state. Mpuuga made the demand during a press conference at parliament in relation to recent explosions that claimed two lives in two separate attacks, and the first explosion went off in Komamboga, a suburb of Kampala, claiming the life of one Emily Nyinaneza, while the other was on a Bushenyi bound bus and claimed the life of one Isaac Matovu. Both attacks have been linked to the Allied Democratic Forces, that is the ADF, and Mpuuga wondered why the country's security agencies did not take seriously an alert by the UK government of a possible terror attack, and instead offered assurances of their readiness to deal with any form of threats. And according to the police, the Kamamboga attackers used an improvised explosive device at the popular hangout, leaving at least one person dead and scores others injured. A day later, a suspected suicide bomber blew up himself aboard Mbarara-bound bus at Lungala in PG along the Kampala-Masaka Highway. Mpuuga encouraged the population to cooperate with the security because terror is indiscriminate, and advised them to be vigilant and report appropriately. Therefore, he wants to warn the general public to avoid being used in circumstances where the state is so desperate. And he also said, making reference to statements by an attendant at a pork joint in Kamamboga, who said one of the attackers was wearing a red beret, meaning it must have been people power. The kind of conduct is dangerous to the public, and some of us who have been here for a long time know how the Ugandan state works, and the public should desist from being used by the state in ignorance by exploiting their gullibility, as he said. He also appealed to the government to avoid using the resurgence of the terror as an opportunity to settle political scores. Whereas terrorism breeds desperation, government should not act desperately. When citizens are scared, the government has a duty to continue assuring the public that they are in charge, and when they hear stories of accusations without proper investigations, including accusations against political groupings, therefore their understanding is that the government would have elected not to investigate but to act in haste and lose an opportunity to investigate and get to the bottom of investigations, as Mathias Mpuuga said. Well, that is it for now, and according to Mathias Mpuuga, he wants the government to stop using terror attacks to settle their political matters. Thanks for watching PROJOURN Media TV. We'll keep on updating with more of this. Just kindly do one thing. Tap on the notification button, subscribe. All these top stories will be coming to you in time. Once again, thanks for watching PROJOURN Media TV.